Welcome into the Upstate Warm-Up, your look ahead to USC Upstate basketball. This weekend, the Spartans welcome the Winthrop Eagles to the G.B. Hodge Center for games, of course, today at 4 and tomorrow at 2 o'clock. The Spartans are coming off of a 672-69 defeat to Georgia Southern last Saturday here at the Hodge Center. Upstate played basically its best game of the year so far. They had four players in double figures, including Bryson Mazzone with 13. And Georgia Southern stole the victory with an and-one opportunity. Went up to the basket with under a second to play, converted the basket and the foul, and then took the three-point victory from USC Upstate. Now, here, as we mentioned, it is Big South play. And with Winthrop coming to call, we get a chance to catch up with Stacy Palmore and get his thoughts on where the team is heading into the weekend. Let's take a trip around the Big South, as we'll discuss later with Mark Bryant from the Big South office. The schedule is always fluid. First, Charleston Southern at Duke was canceled as Duke eliminated their remaining non-ACC slate. High Point and UNC Asheville series was shifted back one day from a Friday-Saturday back-to-back to now a Saturday-Sunday schedule. And also Gardner-Webb hits the road to face Pitt. The Upstate women will travel to Old Dominion on Sunday afternoon before opening Big South play at Winthrop on Thursday, December 17. Before we take a timeout, special thanks to Clayton Construction, a proud supporter of USC Upstate Athletics. Clayton Construction has worked diligently for over 35 years to build a solid reputation built on excellence. Learn more about one of the South's leading general contractors at claytonconstruction.net.
It's in our hearts to feel for you. There's been ups and downs, turnarounds, good days and some bad. But we stand together for worse and for better. We'll always have your back. With open arms, heart to heart, hand in hand. Community strong.
Where we find common ground, cheering together in unity. It's a foundation of founders and a staple of every team we support in our community. Things look different now. But when you get back to the court, back to the field, back to the diamond, we'll be right there too, with our support, just like always. Relax, you're with founders.
Welcome back to the Upstate Warm-Up. Hey, after every Spartan victory, be sure and check out our social media feeds as you can score yourself a special promo code for 50% off your online order the day after any Spartan Hoops victory. That's from Papa John's, proud supporter of your USC Upstate Spartans. It's time now in the show to visit with our men's basketball staff. And earlier, we had a chance to catch up with assistant coach Stacy Palmore. Visiting now with Stacy Palmore, assistant coach and our acting head coach during games and practices. Stacy, you got the Winthrop Eagles, the start of Big South play. It's the middle of December, and here we are already looking at conference games. And let's start out looking back a little bit. And, you know, the team put some really good minutes together, came really close against Georgia Southern. But you and I have talked separate, and there's some progress really being made with the guys. There's been flashes, and really Georgia Southern was the first. Almost all 40 minutes got there. And sure. A little tough at the end, but talk about what guys' attitude has been since the last game and what y'all been working on in practice since then.
It's been really encouraging to see the progress. The results are not there yet, but I think those are happening behind closed doors every day in practice with our guys in film sessions, and seeing sometimes is believing. Things that you emphasize in the games and in practice. And then once you guys see themselves on film, you know, we use the term the eye in the sky don't lie. But the competitive spirit and the work ethic has been really, really good the last week. And I think we're really, really trending in the right direction. And, you know, and it's a good time to be going in that direction with conference play because it's a new season. And, you know, anything goes. So we're just taking it one game at a time, even though we got a back-to-back. But the first game is the most important game, which is on Saturday, you know?
Yeah. One of the guys has really been a spark for you this year that last year was a role player for you off the bench is Kadarius Smith. He's more than doubled his minutes in the game. He was super active on the boards against Georgia Southern. Really seems to give you a great energy this year. And talk
growth Kadarius has had so far this year?
Well, he's a first-class human being, and he's truly a student athlete. He's very, very mature for his age, and I tease with him all the time. I say, use the gifts that God gave you athletically, where you could run, you could jump, you're explosive. And he's starting to buy into that and realize how good he could be. He has flashes sometimes where he'll kind of phase out a little bit, but we try to keep him engaged and throw different challenges at him every day. And one of the things that has sparked his thing is, he competes a lot every day against Nevin Zink, and Nevin is one of those guys who has a high competitive drive. And he spends a lot of time on and off the court with Kadarius. So he's kind of taking Kadarius on his wing. And with Kadarius, he could be really, really good. And he's been good for us so far. He'll continue to get more minutes. And I think with more minutes, his production will continue to get even higher. And that's what we need.
Your opponent this weekend, Winthrop, we'll get to the oddity of the schedule of playing them back-to-back, but tell us what you've seen so far out of the Eagles. They've only played two games this so far this year. Both of those were in Louisville against UNCG and Little Rock.
Right.
Haven't played in about a week, the way their schedule fell out. What have you seen so far out of the Eagles, a team that you guys, battled harder with last year?
Yeah, we did. We played them three times last year, and two of the games were tied at halftime, I think. And so they're a good team. They lost some two big pieces from last year's team, but they got a lot of guys coming back. They got two of their main clogs, I think Jones and Claxton. I don't know if they'll play this weekend or not, but they haven't played. But they're playing about 10, 11 guys. And it's one of the most unique things, and I give their coaching staff credit. They play guys in about 2 to 3 to 4 minute spurts. I mean, you'll see every dead ball, every horn, there's two guys coming to the scores table. And one of the unique things about watching them, those guys are happy for those minutes, and they try to be as productive for however long they're in the game. So because they play a lot of guys, you can't necessarily key on a guy, so you got to hold this guy from getting 30 and you're going to win. They just play a lot of guys. So scouting reports are key in terms of personnel, what guys could do. And their system is really, really good with how they play. They want to get layups, or they want to get threes, and they want to try to score on you early. And they're good, great size. They all, with the exception of five man, is 6'5", 6'6", 6'3". So they're very, very interchangeable. So we got to do a good job defensively, getting our defense set, being sound, and guarding the ball and keeping and containing and not letting them get off threes. That's going to be big for us.
Have you spent a lot of time talking to the team about the change in the schedule? I mean, it's all been written down now for a couple months, I suppose. And here we are, you're going to play the same team. It's not like baseball when you get different pitchers out there against the same team. This is generally the same group, same ball, same gym. Have you talked to the team about, dialing it up and, hey, don't get too down or up about what happens, I guess, the day before. You got to run it back out there again.
A little bit. It's been like a next game type of mentality. And then, to be honest with you, there's so much other stuff going on with COVID-19 and protocol and, hey, you guys got to get tested today. Get to the testing center early because the lines are long. So now we're here. And we talked a little bit about it, about staying in the moment. And we've tried to make a big push, I think, which will help us in situations like this. And a lot of people may think it's a small point, but we really think it's big, is getting proper rest and making sure we eat well. Because you're going to need that. And then the other thing is to be ready when your number's called, because it's not going to be an eight-man rotation. I mean, you got to dig into your bench to save guys and keep guys fresh. So that's the beauty about it, and hopefully we'll get some good production from our bench players and our guys that are coming off the bench, because that's going to be needed, because it's a unique situation.
Yeah, well, good luck. It'll be Winthrop Saturday at 4 and then again Sunday at 2. And we'll look forward to visiting with you, you know, after those games. Stacy, good luck, and we'll talk to you next time.
All right. Thank you, man.
Thank you. That's Stacy Palmore. More of the Upstate Warm-Up right after this.
Upstate, it's where global commerce and nature's beauty live in harmony. It's where the next generation of leaders is rising. It's $500 million to our economy each and every year. Perhaps most important, it's where lifelong bonds are forged. It's our time. It's our place. It's our pride. It's our university.
We're about halfway home here on the Upstate Warm-Up, getting you ready for USC Upstate and Winthrop this afternoon. We're here live in the Ingles Champion Suite. Ingles, the official supermarket of your USC Upstate Spartans, and they bring you now your student athlete spotlight. We talked earlier with Coach Palmore about Kadarius Smith, and now you get the chance to know him a little better as Scout Hoffmeyer visits with Kadarius Smith.
This is Scout Hoffmeyer back here with the Upstate Warm-Up, and I am lucky enough to be talking to Mr. Kai Smith, a sophomore on the men's basketball team. Kai, although you are just from Fort Mill, South Carolina, what drew you to the Upstate area?
What drew me here was like, you know, there's like not a lot going on out here in Spartanburg. You know, it's a quiet city, quiet town, you know, and I feel like that was good for my progressing and, you know, staying on the radar.
Absolutely. Absolutely. This season, you have seen your playing time double over the first four games. Are you expecting to reset each of your career highs every time you walk out onto the floor?
Well, I'm looking to, you know, just bring energy. And, you know, every time I step out on the court, I'm just, you know, just making plays. You know, whatever comes to me. And you know, that's about it.
I love it. I love it. Over your first four games this season, you have only missed two shots so far. What has been the key to your consistent scoring in each of these games?
A lot of late nights and early mornings in the gym. Just putting in work on and off the court, just leads me to be comfortable and, you know, just make shots at a high level every night.
I can totally attest to that. You're in there before I am, and that's hard to beat. It's very hard to beat. It is clear through the first few games this season that you have put a strong emphasis on shot blocking. With 8 blocks through the first few games, how are you expecting to stay aggressive on defense?
Just to use my athleticism and just being aware of, you know, where people are, where the ball handlers are on the court. I got to protect my paint.
I love it. What are your individual goals for the rest of the year?
Just to be ready when my name is called. That's just, you know, big emphasis, just, you know, rebounding, shot blocking and making shots, competing at a high level every single game.
Well, Kai, I wish you the best of luck on the rest of your season, and thank you for allowing me a few minutes of your busy day today.
All right. Thank you so much.
This has been Scout Hoffmeyer with the Upstate Warm-Up, and tune in for tonight's matchup on ESPN+. Thanks y'all so much.
Customer needs assistance on aisle 12.
Check up on the South's most high-tech nursing lab. These students are the future of healthcare in the Upstate, and they might be taking care of you someday. Get to know us at uscupstate.edu.
Time now for your stat of the day, presented by the South Carolina Education Lottery. And today we give a tip of the cap to Denisha Wilson of our USC Upstate women's basketball team, who this week was named the Big South Player of the Week by College Sports Madness. Wilson helped lead the Spartans to a 2-1 record on the week, notching 12 points, 6 assists, and 5 boards at Alabama. She rang up 19 points in the home opening victory over St. Andrews and followed that up with 7 boards and 16 points in the win over Flagler. The 5'3 guard making an impact right out of the gate for Coach Becky Burke's team. Congratulations to Denisha Wilson on being named College Sports Madness Big South Player of the Week. Now, an interesting stat brought to you by the South Carolina Education Lottery. Since 2002, the lottery has provided more than $5.7 billion for South Carolina students. Playing for fun is a win for education. More of the Upstate Warm-Up right after this.
I remember when I was a little girl and maybe I had a tough day at school. I'd come home, go up the stairs to my room, and turn on some music on my boombox. because I knew that the music would make me feel a certain way. Music had a certain healing quality to it. And with the help of my life scholarship, I was able to major in music performance so that I could help bring that healing quality to others. I still think about it sometimes too, like when I walk out on stage or the moment the conductor lifts their baton and the room full of people fall silent, waiting to be inspired or comforted, seeking healing, and I get to help them find whatever it is that they're looking for. I get to be a part of that.
Hey, thanks to our friends at Vic Bailey Automotive for their support of USC Upstate Athletics. From new to pre-owned, they've got hundreds of vehicles either on the lot or online. Shop right now at VicBaileyAuto.com. Time now to check in with the Big South Conference office over in Charlotte. And earlier, we had a chance to catch up with Mark Bryant, the Director of Broadcast Services and Development for the Big South.
Back here on the Upstate warm-up, joined by Mark Bryant from the Big South Conference office. And Mark, it has been an interesting year for those of us on campus. I'm sure it's been very interesting for those of you in Charlotte at the conference office. Talk a little bit about how you guys have adjusted. Speaking of adjusting, I mean, the schedule is one constant adjustment. But how have y'all been dealing with things here over the last, few months?
Well, it is, as you know, it is tough being a sports league with no sports. It was rough to see seasons get pulled away, sports get pulled off the books one by one till there was nothing left, and lots of questions about what the fall would bring. We were very fortunate the Big South did not have to furlough, lay off anybody. The staff, it's a small staff, but we were able to hang on with the idea that we were going to be playing at some point and preparing toward that end, but being careful not to over-prepare on some things too early because you knew it wasn't going to be permanent. Best laid plans and all that. And it was a matter of finding out what else we could do to help people and what other alternatives we could do in media, PR, social media areas. We did a membership recognition campaign where every week we were saluting a different school with a lot of posts focused on that school. That's something we never would have had the time for during an active season. So this was a good alternative to at least show everybody that we're still connected to the membership. But yeah, it's been tough, but there was always the hopes that there was a light on the horizon that we could focus on. And so here we are playing ball.
Yeah, and that light has been the basketball season. That's been the first one to come up, other than some of our football affiliate members have played some non-conference games and whatnot. But basketball is here, and the Big South adopted a back-to-back format. We've talked about that earlier with Coach Palmore, and I don't know how much, I've also had this conversation with our baseball coach here. You know, it's pretty easy for softball, baseball. You play back-to-backs all the time, but you're playing with a different pitcher. You're playing with a few different people in the lineup. This is basically the same five people, potentially. Same floor, same ball. It's so different, but half of Division I is doing this, so talk a little bit about where the Big South came up with this and really the why behind why we are doing the back-to-back.
Right. Well, obviously in a tournament atmosphere, that kind of thing happens all the time. It's just you don't expect to be doing it as frequently as you would over the course of a regular season. The why is fairly simple in terms of dealing with the pandemic and trying to get in as many games in as possible on each opportunity. So rather than do a home and home where you're doubling the travel, if you can get the two teams together in one place, and everybody's tested negative, then you've got your own quasi bubble for a weekend that you can work within, get the games in, get them counted, because there are certain minimums you're supposed to hit. And so the goal is to get in as many games as you can before somebody does test positive, take somebody out of the loop for a while. And that's going to happen. In fact, it's already happening. We've got a game that was in conference play this weekend that's not going to happen. But right now, those aren't cancellations, they're postponements. We're trying to find other places for them in the schedule. But the back-to-backs were a way of both dealing with virus protocols and maximizing our number of games per attempt. And that's really what it comes down to.
And the schedule was built with the idea that postponements were going to happen, and there's just a matter of, you know, where you slot them in, and then hopefully not too many more of them happen, because eventually you do kind of run out of time probably, but certainly been a fluid time, and right. No fluid than our friends at ESPN, and we certainly as a league have an ESPN Plus package. All of us on our own campuses are producing that content, and to look at that schedule of postponements around the country and this, that, and the other, I would hate to be who's keeping track of that at the mothership.
Well, there's a team in scheduling, and I've told them when I've been sending changes in, I don't envy their position. You know, we've got 11 schools, and we've already had just so many games moved, canceled, postponed, time shifting, day shifting. And we report those to ESPN so that they're up on what we're doing, but they're dealing with hundreds of schools doing the same thing nationwide. So their schedule isn't just a slide puzzle. It's an infinite number of slide puzzles to fit together. So yeah, they've got a lot going on their end. But the bottom line for us is we're trying to, with fans not being able to get in particular, we want to be sure those streams happen. So we're maintaining our deal to do all the home basketball and try to satisfy that as much as possible. There may be times along the way where either because of virus things or because of technical things we can't, but we're going to try and do as many basketball games as we can, men's and women's. And folks just have to be, just like us, just got to be flexible with the schedule. Every day there's another school saying, well, we're not going to play school X because they had a positive, or we're not going to play school Y because they're not traveling right now, they're under quarantine, and so on and so on. We don't want to see it hit within the league too much. We've seen it happen to enough smaller schools that were on the non-conference schedule. But if it starts happening prevalently in the league, then we'll obviously have some issues. But just full steam ahead right now is what you kind of have to do. There's not much alternative if you want to get the games in, if you want to proceed toward the tournament, the championships at the end of all this, and the NCAA big dance and all of that that goes with it, that everybody lost last year on right. the men's side.
COVID notwithstanding, talk a little bit about our relationship with ESPN and how much we use the ESPN Plus platform, which continues to grow for ESPN. I know the schedule's a little different this year and things are a little wonky as far as that goes, but in general, talk about our ESPN Plus arrangement.
Well, in a normal year, this is anything but in what goes for a normal year, we would do several hundred, up eight to 900 even events league-wide on ESPN networks. Now, the lion's share of that is going to be on ESPN Plus. That's the basic large-scale level that a lot of the games happen on for us and many, many other leagues across the country. So we have this deal with them for long term to get all our content on the ESPN family of networks and exclusively on the ESPN family of networks. So most of it winds up through ESPN Plus. There is a package that winds up on ESPN 3 and then an assortment of games, wildcard games that go on ESPNU and some championships that go on ESPNU. Typically, the men's basketball championship winds up on the main ESPN network. So we do kind of cover the gamut of the four letter, as they say, and the worldwide leader and all that. We're a small part of a big, big family with that. And so what comes with that is brand recognition, name recognition. I know a lot of coaches love to say to recruits that all their games will be on ESPN. The plus may be somewhat mumbled on the end of that, but the fact is they are within that umbrella. And so anybody with the app and it's subscribing is going to be able to get that game just as much as they do the major Power Five game that's in the same area.
That's right. It's a great platform, and we were fortunate last year to lead the Big South in number of minutes watched, number of unique viewers. So we know a lot of people out there are watching, and we know some of that platform is growing by leaps and bounds as more people go to streaming devices and things of that nature, taking TV with you. So, Mark, we appreciate your time and everything that you guys in Charlotte do for us to help keep us straight with all the changes and everything, and I hope we can catch up again soon.
Very good. We wish everybody the best of holidays and stay healthy and safe out there.
Amen to that. Back with more of the Upstate Warm-Up right after this.
Step up. We've all got dreams, right? Let's reach for them. So, stand up. The stage is set, and we're here to foster aspirations every day. Catch up on the generations who've been improving life in the Upstate. Leaders, caretakers, builders. We're giving them a place to shine. Get to know us at uscupstate.edu.
Final segment here on the warm-up as we count you down for USC Upstate and Winthrop. Today on ESPN Plus and the CW62, Pete Yannity and Richmond Weaver have the call. You can catch the ball game again on WYCW Channel 62. That is anywhere in the Greenville, Spartanburg, Anderson, Asheville TV market. Tomorrow's contest on Sunday afternoon, 2 o'clock, also on ESPN Plus and the CW62. Till next time, Lenny Mathis saying so long from the English Champion Suite. Enjoy USC Upstate basketball all weekend, and happy holidays from all of us here at USC Upstate.